Hello everyone, my name is Rob and I'm a postdoctoral scientist based in Vienna, Austria. In this video, I tested the heart rate accuracy of the Huawei Watch Fit and I found it performed pretty good. It did even better than some of the more premium devices like the Fitbit Sense. I compared the Watch Fit against the Polar H10 chest strap, which is generally considered to be one of the most accurate consumer devices available for heart rate measurements. As always, I don't want to waste your time, so timestamps are in the description below and also on the timeline. To do the analysis, I extracted the raw heartbeat-to-heartbeat data from the Polar H10 and I downloaded my raw heart rate data from Huawei. Finally, I wrote some nerdy computer code to analyze the two. Let's have a look at the results. Let's first look at an example for one workout I did. So this is one spinning session with the time on the horizontal axis and my heart rate on the vertical axis. The Huawei Watch Fit is plotted in red. And the Polar H10, which we're using as a reference, is plotted in blue. I divided my spinning session into four parts where I took a break in between each of them. And as you can see, they agree pretty well overall. The only thing I can see is that for the first session, the Watch Fit had a slight delay in picking up my increased heart rate. And overall, it's just a few BPM below the actual value it should be. Now in total, I did 5 spinning sessions and 2 weightlifting sessions. So let's look at some others as well. Now, this is another spinning session, and this is actually divided into 5 parts. And I actually had some problems with my equipment in between, that's why there are these longer breaks. But overall, we see a similar pattern where the Watch Fit and the Polar H10 agree pretty well, but the Watch Fit has a slightly lower heart rate. Now, here's another spinning session. This is only divided into 3 parts. And as you can see here, they agree very well. There's only this slight delay here, but otherwise, the Huawei Watch Fit is pretty spot on. Now here I plotted my heart rate during a classical weightlifting session. And as you can see, each set comes with a raise in heart rate. So each peak here in blue is one set that I did. And as you can see, the Watch Fit generally follows these patterns, but it has some difficulty picking up the actual peaks in heart rate. Here at the end, it does a little bit better, but in the beginning it struggles a little bit, but overall it's not bad. Now we can combine all this data and make a single comparison plot out of it. This plot displays all of the data I showed you so far, with each dot being a single heart rate measurement. On the horizontal axis is my heart rate according to the Polar H10, and on the vertical axis my heart rate according to the Huawei Watch Fit. This blue diagonal line here indicates where measurements should be if they agree perfectly between the Watch Fit and the Polar H10. And as you can see, almost all heart rate measurements are along this line. Here we have my higher heart rate that I had during spinning. And as you can see, all measurements are pretty close, but if they deviate, they're a bit below the blue line, indicating that my heart rate was a little bit lower according to the Watch Fit than according to the Polar H10, which is what we saw before. But overall, I'm very satisfied with this result. So, how does the heart rate accuracy of the Watch Fit compare to the heart rate accuracy of other, maybe more established devices like the Apple Watch and Fitbit? Well, I recently tested 4 of these, so let's have a look at those results. On the left here, we see the heart rate accuracy of the Watch Fit, the plot that we saw before. And then on the right, we see 4 other devices. So we have the Garmin Venue SQ here on the top left, the Withings Scanwatch here on the top right, the Apple Watch on the bottom left, and the Fitbit Sense on the bottom right. And as you can see, out of all of these, only the Apple Watch really performs better than the Huawei Watch Fit. We can see that the Fitbit Sense often predicts a too low heart rate much more consistently than we see for the Huawei Watch Fit. And the same is true for the Withings Scanwatch. I showed you before in another video that this often predicts half the heart rate that it should predict, which is why we have this cloud of points here and here. And in my hands, the Garmin Venue SQ also had a lot of problems, sometimes predicting too low a heart rate and sometimes predicting too high a heart rate. Now this one I'm gonna retest because I had it set to smart mode, so it might perform better in the continuous mode. So that video will follow. Overall, if we compare, we can really see that the only one that outperforms the Huawei Watch Fit is the Apple Watch. The Apple Watch is super consistent. As I mentioned before, especially when I have a higher heart rate, The Watch Fit sometimes predicts slightly too low a heart rate, but only by a few BPM, and not as severely as we see in the other plots here for the other devices. And also here in the medium range heart rates, it's sometimes a bit too low, but mostly very consistent. Now, last week, after I finished this analysis, I wanted to make sure that results were consistent. So I collected data for one more spinning session and one more weightlifting session. And to my surprise, results were a little bit worse. Now, these are the results for that spinning session. And as you can see, the results are much further off than they were before. And when I looked at my weightlifting session, which you can see here, you can also see that the heart rate was much further off. Now, I started thinking why this could be, and this was actually the first time that I'd worn the Apple Watch on the same wrist as where I wore the Watch Fit. So my theory was that the Apple Watch was pushing up against the Watch Fit, which meant it couldn't make good contact with my skin. So to be even more sure of my results, I wore it for two more spinning sessions. And these are the results. So this is the first spinning session. And again, the Watch Fit agrees very well with the Polar H10. And the spinning session the next day, again, we see very good agreement. So probably indeed, the Apple Watch was pushing a little bit against the Watch Fit, preventing good contact with the skin and thereby messing up the heart rate measurements. I have to say that the Huawei Watch Fit is surprisingly accurate when it comes to heart rate measurements, also considering its price, especially when we compare it to more premium devices like the Fitbit Sense or the Apple Watch. Honestly, the Fitbit Sense performs worse than the Huawei Watch Fit, though a recent software update might have solved this, and that's something I'll test in the future. The only small problems I encountered with the Watch Fit is that it sometimes underestimates my heart rate just by a little bit, maybe a few BPM, and that it struggles a little bit more with my weightlifting sessions, where it misses some of the spikes in my heart rate. Also, I use the Huawei Health app on my iPhone, and originally this had a lot of problems syncing with the actual watch. However, after a recent firmware update of the watch, this doesn't really seem to be a problem anymore, but this might be something you want to look out for. Compared to other devices, the touchscreen and the watch interface of the Watch Fit are good, and they feel pretty premium. It handles much better than, for instance, the Garmin Venue SQ, and I personally feel that the interface and the operating system of the watch are pretty close to the quality of the Fitbit Sense. The Apple Watch is in a league of its own though when it comes to its smart features and its interface, so don't expect Apple Watch quality. However, I picked up the Huawei Watch Fit for about $100, which is only a fraction of what you pay for more premium devices. Based on my results so far, I would definitely say it's worth considering buying the Watch Fit if you're interested in decent heart rate tracking and you don't want to spend a lot of money. In my videos, I do scientific tests on different devices like the Oura Ring, the Fitbit, and the Scanwatch. And in the next few weeks, I'll start testing the Watch Fit. So if you like that subject and like this video, consider subscribing to my channel. And also consider giving it a thumbs up because it makes it easier for other people to find my videos. For now, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video.